The prediction we've been thinking about for weeks has finally come true. There will be no launch scheduled for this month. Flight 9 has been delayed significantly due to several technical complications, specifically related to Ship 25. What exactly happened to cause this situation? On a positive note, SpaceX Falcon 9 has officially resumed flight after a brief hiatus, easing concerns about potential ongoing complications with the rocket. At the same time, NASA's most experienced astronaut, Don Pettit, marked a major milestone by returning from the ISS. Let's dive deeper. In today's episode of NR Studio, we'll cover all of these topics in depth. Most importantly, Flight 9 is being watched with great anticipation and high expectations, especially after the previous two flights faced significant challenges. Many had hoped that the mission would launch in April, based on the timeline set by Flight 8 and SpaceX's usual post-flight procedures. However, recent developments, most notably the slow progress of the B-14 and S-35, have changed that schedule. Internal sources indicate that the launch is now anticipated to be delayed until mid-May. What factors are causing these delays? Let's examine the progress of both phases more closely. Starting with B-14, after a successful static firing test, the transfer of the boosters to Mega Bay 1 took several days. This raised concerns among some observers who speculated about potential underlying problems. Fortunately, recent imagery depicting its advanced staging system has somewhat alleviated those concerns, indicating that B-14 is making consistent progress. The main issue currently being faced is Ship 35. Its progress has been extremely slow. Cryogenic testing ended on March 13th, and the following day, S-35 was returned to Mega Bay 2. However, significant progress apparently remained elusive until almost a month later, specifically on the 8th of this month, when the rear cover was finally installed. A few days later, on the 13th, the arrival of its engines alongside the lifting rig indicated that preparations for the upcoming move were underway. However, 2 weeks later, S-35 remains motionless. A plausible explanation is that the ship is currently awaiting critical components. Given the insights gained from the challenges faced during Flights 7 and 8, SpaceX likely made a series of upgrades and modifications. These upgrades, likely intended to increase reliability, may incorporate new engineering systems that require additional time for installation and verification. As a result, each delivery to Mega Bay 2 gained substantial importance, indicating progress in vehicle upgrades. It appears that SpaceX implemented a more stringent inspection protocol on this occasion. For example, after completing a series of cryogenic tests, it is assumed that components, including the fuel tank, are undergoing a thorough inspection. These prudent steps indicate that SpaceX is prioritizing a thorough verification of all systems before proceeding. A particularly important focus is the heat shield. Visual modifications observed on the S-35 suggest that SpaceX may have re-engineered certain features, perhaps to improve re-entry survivability. This indicates a clear intent not only to survive re-entry, but to excel in it. Another area that is poised for additional inspection is the engine compartment. Given the repeated setbacks observed during the last two flights, it is reasonable to assume that SpaceX is conducting a thorough assessment and possibly upgrading of critical components, including the ventilation ports, nitrogen-powered filtration system, fire suppression mechanisms, and primary fuel supply lines. Installation of the engines will occur only after these inspections and upgrades are complete. They will then undergo a series of additional checks to ensure peak performance before moving on to static firing tests. Collectively, these steps contribute to the extended timeframe, explaining the lack of progress on the S-35 thus far. While movement has begun, it has not yet begun its long journey ahead. A series of static test firings, comprehensive post-test evaluations, payload system integration, and installation of the flight termination system are underway. The transportation of the S-35 and B-14 to the launch site is dependent on the completion of these tasks. Nevertheless, both vehicles are required to undergo a wet dress rehearsal to ensure complete readiness, followed by a final system evaluation. However, the delays are not solely due to vehicle preparation. SpaceX must also cooperate with the Federal Aviation Administration. Although SpaceX has been cleared to proceed with the launch amid the ongoing investigation, it remains dependent on obtaining an official launch license from the FAA. Meanwhile, efforts to remediate environmental contamination are actively underway. Importantly, Bahamian authorities recently launched an investigation into possible debris from the Starship landing, a scenario that could be related to the anomaly observed during Flight 8. This goes beyond mere regulatory formalities. The importance of safeguarding the public's well-being cannot be overstated, especially considering the fact that Falcon 9 booster landings have occurred in the vicinity of the site. All things considered, a mid-May launch makes much more sense. This gives SpaceX a significant amount of time to complete upgrades, conduct thorough testing, and secure necessary regulatory approvals. It's no doubt a bit of a disappointment for fans who were anticipating back-to-back Starship flights in March and April, an event that hasn't happened since April 2023. Right now, success is more important than speed. A fully successful ninth flight would significantly increase confidence in Starship future. So even if it's a few more weeks, let's continue to support the team. If you agree that success is more important than anything else, please share your thoughts in the comments section below. If you haven't already, we kindly encourage you to like the video and subscribe, as your support will go a long way toward our goal of reaching 10,000 subscribers. That support is very important to us. Now let's move on to the latest developments regarding the Falcon 9 program. On April 20th at 8:29 a.m. Eastern Time, SpaceX successfully launched a Falcon 9 rocket from SLCE at Vandenberg Space Force Base in California. The operation, dubbed NROL-148-5, was conducted on behalf of the United States. The National Reconnaissance Office, NRO, successfully deployed a new fleet of classified reconnaissance satellites into orbit. While the specifics are limited due to the sensitive nature of the payload, it is thought that the satellites are a more advanced iteration of SpaceX Starlink platform, equipped with cutting-edge surveillance technology as part of the Starshield initiative. Starshield was carefully engineered to support government-oriented initiatives, featuring advanced features such as secure communications, terrestrial observation, and additional enhancements. After liftoff, the Falcon 9 first-stage booster, B-1082, executed its mission with impeccable precision, successfully completing its 12th mission by landing on a drone ship positioned in the Pacific Ocean. Unlike conventional SpaceX operations, the live broadcast ended immediately after the booster landing at the NRO request, likely to maintain secrecy regarding the final phase of the mission. NROL-145 marked the 10th launch in support of the NRO rapidly evolving innovative architecture, which consists of a constellation of low-cost small satellites that aims to provide greater speed and adaptability in surveillance activities. In a post-launch statement, NRO Director Chris Skelly underscored the importance of this strategy by stating that having many small satellites in orbit is essential to the NRO mission. These satellites will increase revisit rates, extend reach, facilitate more timely information dissemination, and ultimately help us meet our customers' needs at a higher rate. SpaceX also announced at X that it successfully launched a Falcon 9 with NROL-145-5 from California, marking the completion of our first mission under the new National Security Missions contract awarded in October 2024. The mission is of particular significance because it marks the resumption of Falcon 9 operations after a temporary hiatus. The hiatus was said to stem from difficulties SpaceX encountered with landing the booster on an unmanned ship located in the Bahamas. Fortunately, the company's dual coastal capabilities provide the flexibility to continue launching from California, allowing SpaceX to maintain its momentum while navigating technical challenges. While SpaceX overcame the challenges of landing in the Bahamas, the successful completion of the NROL-145 mission highlighted the robustness and adaptability of the Falcon 9 system. Through continued progress in a diverse range of missions, SpaceX is strategically poised to maintain its leadership in the commercial and government space launch sectors. Finally, to end our discussion on an encouraging note, let's turn to the exciting news of NASA's longest-serving astronaut returning from the International Space Station. Astronaut Don Pettit has made a triumphant return to Earth following a successful landing of his Soyuz MS-26 spacecraft. The capsule landed in Kazakhstan at 9:20 p.m. Eastern Time on April 19th, which corresponds to 6:20 a.m. local time on the 20th. Accompanying Pettit on his return journey were Russian cosmonauts Alexei Avgin and Yapan Bagner. This mission is an integral part of the ongoing astronaut exchange initiative between NASA and Roscosmos, facilitating continued cooperation aboard the International Space Station. In a happy twist of events, Pettit's return coincided with an important personal milestone, his 70th birthday. Born on April 20, 1955, he emerged just hours before the dawn of a new day in Eastern Time, his birthday in Kazakhstan. Starting one's 70th birthday after a space mission is an accomplishment that few can boast. Upon landing, the crew was immediately greeted by a recovery team and medical staff from NASA and Roscosmos, who performed standard health assessments and provided necessary assistance. The three were then transported by helicopter to the nearby city of Karaganda. Don Pettit would then bid farewell to his colleagues and board a NASA aircraft for his journey back to Houston. During his time on the ISS, Pettit meticulously carried out his mission objectives, enhancing ongoing research and operations. He continued to engage in one of his signature activities, taking stunning photographs of the Earth and the cosmos, then sharing these images with a global audience. Astronaut Nicole Ayers shared her sentiments regarding Pettit's passing, saying goodbye to Don Pettit today is bittersweet. His incredible mission was not only incredible, but also inspired so many during his time with us. MS-26 was Pettit's fourth spacewalk, culminating in a total of 590 days spent in orbit. 590 days. His odyssey is a powerful testament to the idea that age is no barrier to making significant contributions to the world of space exploration, and indeed to society as a whole. As NASA's longest-serving active astronaut, Pettit's contributions continue to inspire scientists, engineers, and space enthusiasts around the world. While this may be his final mission, his legacy will surely endure. Through his scientific contributions and the passion he instilled in the discipline, Don Pettit epitomized the essence of exploration and innovation. Let's take a moment together to express our gratitude to Don Pettit. Please share your birthday wishes. That's it for today's episode. See you next time, and thank you for your support.